this part.
I'm your anchor, Mary.
And I'm your anchor, James. Welcome to our third episode of Life in Black and Gold.
Can you believe it's already our third show?
You bet I can. We have a packed show today. So, Mary, why don't you tell us what's going on the show?
Well, you just saw some awesome artwork done by PHS students for Youth Art Month. As we continue our program, we will be talking about the swimming and wrestling teams. We'll also be showing some selections from the choir, band, orchestra, and marching band. Then Emily will give us some interesting facts about the Hunger Games movie.
Sagnick put together a short report on the Piscataway Experience Night, and we'll close out with a segment honoring Women's History Month.
Let's kick it off with the Teacher Talent Show. Take it away, Danny.
Thanks, guys. Hey, everyone. Danny here from Life in Black and Gold. Now, back in November, some of our teachers gathered up some courage, and they took the stage to show off what makes them really special. Now, I know you want to see the full video, but here's just a little teaser of what we have to offer. Now, you can get the full DVD by talking to either Ms. Basculo or Mr. Fairfield in F102, or emailing them at PWAY-TV@PWAY.org. Now, let's go to Emily for her report on the music department.
Thanks, Danny. The students in the band, orchestra, choir, and marching band have to work very hard to be the great musicians they are. Now sit back and relax as we listen to some great selections from recent concerts and competitions.
Four incredible groups of musicians, the orchestra, band, marching band, and choir, all had their days to shine. Let's take a look back at some of those moments. First off, the orchestras. The orchestra and chamber orchestra, in a joint concert with the band, did an amazing job with their concert selections, including wonderful pieces Christmas Time Is Here and Fantasia on Green Sleeves. On to the band. The combined symphonic and concert band, as well as the wind ensemble, did an exceptional job in their concert with selections like the Phantom of the Opera medley, Dusk, and Nevermore, based on The Raven by Edgar Allan Poe. Super Chief Marching Band recently reached the end of their competition season with their show, Four Seasons. Since the beginning of July, they have been working their butts off to produce a great show to compete against some of the best bands in the state. In the end, they won first place at three competitions and won fourth place during finals at Rutgers Stadium. Dr. Summoner and Mr. Zampella are already working on the show for next year, and it is sure to be a great show. And finally, the choir, or should I say, choirs. As there are about six choirs in the school, including the beginning men's, the beginning women's, the advanced women, the concert choir, the chamber choir, and Notoriety, Piscataway High School's a cappella group. They all had their moments in the spotlight at the choir concert, showing off what they learned from their remarkable teacher, Miss Suzo, and their inspiring singing capabilities. That's all for the fall and winter seasons, but our music program is far from over. Look forward to the spring for their next concerts and performances.
Great job, guys, but we can't rest yet. The bands and the orchestra will be having their spring concert on May 17th, and the choir will be holding theirs on May 20th. And we wish you all of the best luck. But before we go back to the studio, here's four facts about the film that took America by storm. Here's four facts about the Hunger Games.
How are you today, Kiki?
I'm great, and you, Jasmine?
Wonderful. Now that the pleasantries are over, we can get to the news. Do you like the Hunger Games by any chance?
Yes, I love the book, and the movie was great too.
Well, you're in luck. We have four facts about the production, locations, cast, and crew of the movie, The Hunger Games. And we all know the over-the-top Effie Trinket, played by Elizabeth Banks. Her makeup depended on the look. It took between 3 and 4 hours to complete, according to an interview done by People, and I thought I took a long time to get ready.
So we all know J-Law, or Jennifer Lawrence, and her famous archery character, Katniss. But did you know that Katniss is a common water plant that is also called Arrowhead? The name was a nod to her character's amazing archery skills.
The whole production took a total of 2 years to complete and started in September of 2010 and wrapped up in February of 2012.
The last fact that we have for today is all the locations in North Carolina were used for the film. They included Shelby for District 12, Pasco National Forest, Asheville for arena scenes, Charlotte for Capitol scenes, and Cranford for Capitol scenes. Hildebrand for District 12, North Fork Reservoir, Black Mountain, Barnardsville, DuPont State Forest, and Cedar Mountain.
That's a lot of locations. North Carolina had a blast with the entire cast there.
I forgot how much goes into making a blockbuster like this, and it's only scratching the surface compared to other movies like Titanic or the Star Wars franchise.
This is Emily Harding, now back to you in the studio.
Thanks for that, Emily. But as much as Mary likes to talk, we have to hand it off to our friend Austin for sports.
Thanks, guys. Finally, my turn. Welcome to the world of Piscataway sports. Today we start with wrestling, and thanks to our interviewer Zach Frage, we have a few words from wrestling finalist and captain, Jordan Cook.
The Piscataway Chiefs wrestling team ended their season with 17 wins and 6 losses and advanced to the state sectional semifinals. We advanced 6 wrestlers to the region tournament, and from there, 3 wrestlers advanced to the state tournament, where sophomore Mike Petit, placed 8th in his weight class, has not been accomplished by any Piscataway wrestler since 2012.
Hello, I'm Zach, and I'm here with the captain of the wrestling team, Jordan Cook. What first got you interested in starting with the sport?
Really just my friends, my family, and when I was a kid playing with my dad.
Wow, that sounds great. What is your biggest accomplishment as a wrestler?
Winning GMCs this year against John Sheedy from Bishop R.
Well, I have to say, I'm impressed. With being team captain, is there a level of responsibility that you feel that you have for the team?
Yeah, I feel that I have to make sure that everybody has to participate to their fullest and work as hard as they possibly can at practice so they can get better during matches.
Wow, that's really impressive. You feel as if there is certain mental aspects of wrestling that have helped aid you academically.
Yeah, it helped me to be disciplined and do all my work as much as I possibly can, aside from after wrestling practice. I don't really have much time, but I do it as much as I possibly can.
Okay, one last question. What is wrestling to you?
Wrestling's family. It's creating a bond with the rest of the team and getting the best experience out of it.
Wow. Thank you for your time, and I hope the best of luck to you in your road to success.
Thank you.
Now on to swimming. Trisha brings us up to date with everything.
When most people think of sports, the first thing they think of is usually football. Today, however, we're going to talk about a sport that doesn't often get a chance at the spotlight. On January 22nd, the Piscataway swim team had a meet against Bishop R, and they did pretty great. On the boys' team, Joe Semenek came in first place in both the 100 breaststroke and the 200 freestyle. Brandon Evers came in first place in both the 50 freestyle and the 100 backstroke. Joel Kincaid placed first in the 200 individual medley and in the 100 butterfly. Daniel Rosales placed second in the 50 freestyle and in the 100 freestyle. Tyrell Dunn came in third in the 50 freestyle. Xerxes Tata came in third place in the 100 butterfly. Joshua Chetta came in third place in the 100 freestyle. Adam Nathu came in second place in the 500 freestyle and the third place in 100 backstroke. And Isaac Nathu came in third place in the 500 freestyle. As for the girls team, Elizabeth Borges came in first place in both the 500 freestyle and the 100 backstroke. Olivia Luckshides came in first place in the 100 freestyle as well as first place in the 50 freestyle. Antonia Simeonek came in first place in the 100 breaststroke and second place in the 200 freestyle. Ashley Yotis came in third place in the 200 freestyle. And Emma Brogy got second place in both the 200 individual medley and the 100 breaststroke. Congratulations to all of our amazing swimmers and good luck next season.
Congratulations to the boys and girls bowling teams for another successful season. Congrats to all the boys' varsity water wearers. Like a swinging vine, swing my heart across the line. In my face is flashing signs. Seek it out and ye shall find. Old, but I'm not that old, young. Give another round of applause to all the girls' varsity letter winners. You go, girls. Great job, and here's to another successful season.
I'm Austin Ferguson with Piscataway Sports. Back to you, Mary and James.
Thanks, Austin. The Piscataway Experience, a night dedicated to showing 8th grade students and their families what our high school has to offer. Here is Stagnick's report.
Looking most forward to when you enter the high school?
I'm looking forward to the drama club because I like doing musicals. I did all 3 musicals for my middle school, so that's the one thing that I'm definitely looking forward to.
What do you enjoy most about choir?
I probably enjoy the feeling of togetherness because all of us in the choir really feel like a family, and it's definitely one of the best experiences I've had during high school.
I think that today's event is a really outstanding way for the high school to showcase the depth and breadth of our offerings, and I think it's great that there's so many opportunities here at Piscataway High. I mean, anything that any student is interested in, it's here for them. I was actually just telling my son, who's a rising 8th grader, that all he has to do is figure out what he's interested in, and the high school will do the rest. It's here.
What's one piece of advice you could give to incoming 8th graders about high school so they can succeed?
For many incoming 8th graders, you know, the idea is that the more clubs I join, the better it is, the more chances I get into getting into the college of my dreams. But I'd like to say that that's not exactly how it works. Rather pick a few select clubs that you're genuinely interested in and try to grow in that. So for example, I joined FBLA and ICCA because I am interested in culture and like that worldly aspect of cosmopolitan view, as well as FBLA because I feel like doing something of business in the future. And so when I was able to pick just two things that I really liked, I was able to move very far in it and was able to achieve success in those two specific clubs.
All right, well, thank you for your time.
That is always a fun night.
Yes, it is. As we all know, March is Women's History Month, and here at Piscataway High School, we are proud to celebrate it as well.
Here's a brief rundown of how Women's History Month came to be.
Every March, we celebrate Women's History Month, but what are the origins of the celebration of female power? Women's History Month was originally recognized as Women's History Week. The celebration originated in 1982 after the week starting on March 7th of that year was proclaimed as Women's History Week by then-President Ronald Reagan. In 1987, after 5 years of work from the public and Congress, all of March became officially recognized as Women's History Month. Women's History Month celebrates the people and rights of women throughout the world. One of the earliest pioneers of female power was French warrior Joan of Arc, who led a large military force in the Hundred Years' War. Over 400 years later, Susan B. Anthony and Elizabeth Cady Stanton had started the National Women's Suffrage Association for the Constitutional Rights of Women. The biggest provision of progress seen for women was the right to vote. In present day, the United States may have gained gender equality, but it took a bit more work in other countries. Malala Yousafzai had laid her life on the line, suffering gunshot wounds from local militia after trying to teach young women how to read and write. So this March, we should all recognize everything that women have been able to accomplish throughout history, and hope for only more in the future.
Lastly, don't forget the PWAY 5K on April 24th. Word has it that the Viking and the Penguin are now being challenged by the seniors, and if they don't win, then Mrs. Chilacos will have to run dressed as a unicorn.
That's all we have for today. Thanks for tuning in. I'm James.
And I'm Mary, and we'll see you next time.
Stay golden, PWAY.